That's 1500 feet a minute. Nearly 1600 feet a minute. Beautiful.
Is my KFA Safari powered by a Rotax 915 engine. I thought today's video would be a review after owning this aircraft for exactly a year now.
This aeroplane. This is a Safari with a Rotax 915 engine. I am very, very impressed in terms of the performance and basically the places that this aeroplane has taken me, the people that I've met, which I think is actually the most important part to all of this aviation stuff. Sure, it can take off short, it can land fairly short, you can get it into pretty tight strips, but you know, the best part about all of this is that I've met some really cool people all over the country. And yeah, that's what we use these aeroplanes for. And I'm ready for takeoff. We'll hold on to the brake. Tail up. 38, rotate. 50 and climb. So as you can see, it is quite the performer. I am at circuit altitude halfway down the runway. Yeah, so this plane has got heaps and heaps of power. And just to give you an idea of the avionics system that I am using, we are using the MGL. And MGL radio, and then it is a little transponder. Yeah, it's pretty well set up for a bush plane. I wish I did have Garmin in here, but unfortunately Garmin is just slightly out of reach in terms of the price range. A few niggles here and there, which you have to work through. And I suppose on the Garmin side, you wouldn't have to work through it as much. Also in this plane, I have a hydraulic constant speed propeller. So this is very similar to like the certified Cessnas, in that you pull the actual controller back and it coarsens out the prop. You push it forward and it finds out the prop. I suppose while we're at it, let's show you another nice thing we can do. Super, super calm warning. These aeroplanes, we can actually open the door. So what we need to do in this aeroplane is slow it down below 70 knots, and I'll open the door and put my arm up. Okay, there we go. We're at 67 knots, let's give it a little bit of flap, and I'm gonna open the door. How stunning is that? And how awesome is this? Door open, super smooth. Everything is just so like relaxed and nice. I can literally do things like this. This is honestly the life. I'll show you how we can actually land this plane with the door open as well. This is quite a nice runway to use if there are strong crosswinds at Petite. Okay, we are short final now. There we are. We landed at the Crops Trails field. You can see that the grass is actually still quite long here. I'm going to shut down quickly. We can have a walk around outside, see what's going on, and then head back to Petite.
We have literally landed in the middle of nowhere, and this is the reason why I own a plane like this, where I can come into, I mean, this strip is definitely not the roughest that this aeroplane can get into, that's for sure. It's extremely long, but the fact that I'm able to come out here into the middle of nowhere, which I wouldn't be able to do with a car, I mean, I'm sure I would, it'd just take a hell of a lot longer. But I mean, here I am on a crop sprays field in the middle of the flippin' cornfield. And this is honestly the life. Not that I want to become a farmer, but I really do enjoy flying my aeroplane out to places like this.
Let's get out of here. So won't you come by, don't you be a stranger, cause you are a friend to me. So just to give you guys an idea of the sort of cruise performance of this aeroplane, we'll cruise probably at about 90 knots, 92 knots, something like that, using about 27 inches of manifold pressure, 5,200 RPM. There's a lot of drag on this aeroplane with the landing gear, the tires, the wings, the whole thing. This plane was designed to fly slowly and not fast. In terms of fuel burn on this aeroplane, I'm probably looking at between 28 and 30 liters per hour, which is fairly thirsty when it comes to Rotax engines. But it's obviously, for the extra horses, the trade-off is more fuel burn. Yeah, I don't know what else to say really. I mean, value for money. This is comes in quite a lot cheaper than a standard Kitfox. So we'll start to set up for the landing now. Final approach speed about 56, 55 knots indicated. This 915 engine is quite heavy. Definitely need quite a lot of aft trim in order to keep the nose up here. Often I do tend to put weight in the back just to balance it out a little bit better. Gonna go full flap. Okay, so the runway will be quite wet now with all the dew that's come over overnight. So the tires will most likely lock and we'll have a nice glide down the runway. Okay, there we go, we're over the top of the trees and slip it down. Okay. And then drag it in for a low approach.